some of that dead, damaged, or diseased part of the tree, this is where we're really going to get into pruning. We're looking to maintain a tree shape that's going to allow light to penetrate through the tree. What that does, again, is it supports high quality fruit. Fruit is able to ripen better and at the correct pace if it has enough light exposure. And so what we're going for is kind of a conical shape to the tree. Right now, David, would you agree this tree is kind of a mushroom shape, right?
I would say so.
It's got a little too much growth at the top.
Yeah, if left to their own devices, this is often what trees do. So yeah. This is where the pruning becomes more critical.
And another thing we're going to look at is overlapping branches. Like right here, we have two limbs that are rubbing up against each other. And one thing that can happen is that can cause some injury and a potential for disease. So we want to prune away overlapping branches and parts of the tree where there's just too many branches in one spot. One of the first things we're going to do is we're going to get rid of these water sprouts. These are these vertical branches that are just going straight up in the middle of the tree. These aren't going to be very productive and they're just going to get in the way. So we're going to prune these off. So let's get started. We have a couple of water sprouts here and here. And there on this branch, this is a good branch. It's a productive branch. It's got fruiting buds on it. We want to keep those. But I am going to cut off these water sprouts. All right, I'm just going to keep pruning some water sprouts off. And I can do these with my small trimmers, but they're almost big enough that we could be using the loppers right now. These are all water sprouts. And I want to do a nice clean cut, as close to the bottom as I can. And this one's a little bigger, I'm going to use my lopper for that. That's why we need a couple different sizes. There. The one in the middle has a couple nice fruiting buds on it, so I want to keep that. And I'm going to take off the two smaller, weaker limbs around it. All right.
So I think we've got a lot of shading going on here when all these limbs are leafed out. There would be a lot of competition for light. So I think we're going to take off one of the major competitors right here and open that up a little bit for better light penetration. The smaller one out of the way. And we have one that's too upright here. Now we have still some crossing and competition in here. I think that one's a little too bulky too. You see now we're reducing the light penetration, or reducing the shading, allowing more light penetration. As we go a little further into the tree, now we see these limbs that are sort of crossing and hanging over each other. So let's make a few corrective cuts there. There's another one, it's a little too upright. Now we've really improved the situation here. You can see the light penetration has greatly increased. We've got a limb now that has nice fruit spurs on it, but we still have one culprit up top. So if I can reach that one, we'll solve that right now. Ah, that's much better. We do have a situation where sometimes we need to cut a branch back to shorten its length, and we have to think about what type of cut we're going to make. That is, where will the cut be made relative to the little buds or branches that are near it? Well, here's a limb that we're going to make some corrections on. But first of all, let me just explain a little bit about what these little short branchlets are. Those are actually fruit buds. That's actually where next year's fruit will be formed, and so we're trying to protect those. We want to choose a fruit bud or a little spur that's growing outward so that it will continue to maintain the shape of the tree that we have. So for example, this is a very nice cut to make. That limb that's left, the little budlet that's growing there, will grow outward, is growing in the right direction. That's in continuity with the shape of the tree. So always remember, respect the nature, the shape of the tree when you make those little small cuts.
Okay, so let's clean up this part of the tree now. You know, we've done some water sprouts and we've cleaned up that higher part of the tree, but let's show how we could clean up this part so that we don't have overlapping branches and we have more light penetration through the tree. So let's think about what we would want to do here.
Yes.
Got a lot of branches in this general area.
We do, yeah.
These two branches are overlapping each
That's
other.
That's right, yeah.
And they're kind of rubbing up against each other. So what would you do about that?
Well, the first thing I would do, as you're right, these two are competing with each other. I would generally prefer, I would favor the tree, the branch that goes, again, with the structure of the tree. This one is growing backwards, really not, we could live with it, but since we have a perfectly nice substitute right above it, we'll just clean that out. So I see this one growing back sort of against the grain. It's overlapping with this one. So I think this would be an easy, smart cut. Now you see we can swing our hand through there much better. As we go up a little further, I still see two here. They could both perhaps have a place, but I think we'd really want to choose one or the other. And I think I would choose the one that's a little more outward growing now. Now you see we're starting to have some room to breathe in here. You can move your hand in there a little better. Have a branch that's growing backward there. Let's clean that out.
Right, we don't want branches going to the inside of the tree. That doesn't
that's
do much
right.
good.
Yeah, very little purpose for a branch like that. We also have a branch here that's hanging downward. It's not in a terrible position, but as those branches grow lower and lower, they tend to be more shaded, they tend to be less vigorous, they tend to have less useful fruit. So I think best to just get that one completely out of.
David, so thanks to your help, we've cleaned up a part of this tree here up in the front. It would take us another half hour or so to prune the rest of the tree, so we're not going to do that today. But at home, you would use these same principles that we've used for this part of the tree to prune your own apple tree in your backyard. So just to sum up what we've talked about in this three-part series, we talked about the importance of pruning to maintain tree shape, fruit quality, and to remove unwanted wood like dead and damaged wood. And then we've talked about how to go about pruning in order to create light penetration through the tree and support fruit quality. So thanks for joining us today. We'll see you next year because you have to prune every winter to maintain tree shape. So we look forward to having a great fruit harvest this summer. Find more information on extension.umn.edu.